Part 8 had explained why Poisson suddenly fought against Big on map 232 and other maps. The difficult first phase on map 232 was to be seen, in which Big had conquered the red-colored area and Poisson could take the blue-colored area at the same time. Big seemed to have achieved a first objective by special losing some very expensive bases. Poisson had secured the north above the river, and on crossing the river, the further attack received fierce opposition. Obviously, Big had previously deployed all groups on the right, but was now anxious to halt Poisson's further advance. Not only running attacks were disrupted to the best of their ability, freshly captured bases were repeatedly counterattacked. Big did everything possible not to lose any more bases. This video can only show some representative excerpts of the fierce battles. In fact, both alliances wrestled with each other for a very long time, deploying many groups over and over again. Both sides felt like these bases were about who would end up owning the map. If Preußen could advance further, the map would be lost to Big sooner or later. On the other hand, if Big could push back Poisson now, it would be very difficult for Poisson to hold onto this map permanently. But in the end, Big had to retreat defeated again and again. Slowly, Poison took more bases and was able to hold them against the counterattacks. To be less predictable, Poison attacked sometimes on the left and sometimes on the right. If Big had moved all troops to the left for defense, they simply attacked on the right. In this way, bases could often be taken with little opposition. And with every base, Poison became stronger on this map. At the same time, Poison fought on other maps, where Poison also had some bases due to the player Special and Chewy, and now completed these. Here you can see map 846 as an early example. For both sides, however, map 232 was particularly contested at this point. Even bases that had already been captured kept coming under fire. Big did not want to retreat. Phases of the fiercest confrontations alternated with phases of mutual harassment. Neither side wanted to give up a single foot of ground. This is not comparable to the clapping of new players on new maps. Here, alliances clashed that by now could each send hundreds of groups from other maps to engage in massive battles for hours. Although Big had fallen to rank 4 in the alliance rankings, Poison was no longer the tiny alliance it had been at the very start of the war. In the meantime, Poison already ranked among the top 10 Desert Order alliances. And not by cheaply bashing new, inexperienced players, but in fierce competition with a still much larger alliance. Without forgetting map 232, map 39 could also be completed. The simultaneous fight on so many maps demanded a lot from Poison. Then there was a very surprising order of the day at Poison. Map 232 was to be attacked only when the opportunity presented itself and concentration was to be placed on map 78. This map was Strabel's home map and therefore of high symbolic importance. Players with enough bases on the home map can build MP4s there for free. This only works well on the home map. If the leader of Big could be deprived on his home map, this would weaken one of the strongest Big players enormously. This motivated Poison especially. However, the opponent was also aware of how important these battles were, and once again everything was done to hold his map against Poison. The battle log of Strabel shows the course of the battles for this map very nicely. In the beginning, Strabel tried to take some bases from Poison, for example against Chewy. Then Poison offensive was underway. From May 29th to June 4th, Preußen fought tirelessly. Strabel alone lost more than 80 bases to Preußen on map 78. Finally, Preußen was able to blow for the grand final on map 78 as well. It must have hit Strabel hard. A few days later, Strabel was no longer the leader of the Big Alliance, not even the co-leader. And it looked as if he had given up completely, at least for the time being. Sometimes it's harder to take it than it is to give it. Strabel had learned this lesson, albeit the hard way. Preußen could then concentrate fully on map 232 again. Now, finally, more Preußen players could get involved here, because some other maps were now pacified. One last time, Strabel could be seen, but he also lost all his bases on map 232. But he was not so strongly represented here. With Strabel's inner abandonment, also the resistance of the part of Big ended. The last bases could then be taken without significant resistance. On June 20th, with the complete capture of map 232, the chapter Preußen against Big could then be considered successfully closed. Who knows what the future may bring for Preußen now?